Doesn't look so bad, neither too good. I have a new seal, it will fix my oil leaks. Oven cleaner, another oven cleaner. Another cleaner. Did my best. It's not immaculately clean. Still some moisture on this wall, but I reckon it's good enough. AGR valve also clean. Should be working fine now. This surface is not very clean, not very smooth, a little bit rusty. I will try to resurface it, and I'm going to be a little bit environmentally friendly. I had to clean some of the chambers, and it's not really like perfect, but it's alright.
New crankshaft seal.
I got a new seal. It's one of them I'm moving easily, and another one's very hard. Completely block re-screws and disassemble it. Doesn't look too dirty, but some of the actuators or flow regulators was completely stuck. The mark is supposed to sit here. Assembling it back. Now it has really free movement. You can see all the flaps are moving easily and forming the airflow. The turbo actuator has a free move. It should be done. The turbo is clean. We'll see.
I have already fabricated this side of the engine hinge. It's going to fit it in like this. On top of that, I'm going to sit like that.
It's supposed to look something like that.
The plate behind the flywheel had few rusts. I just quick blasted it and I will give it a fresh coat.
Fresh coat for the plate. Got the hinge plate installed. Also, I have cleaned the filter.
Oh, this can go to the scrap yard.
Even though this T3 already has a TDI swap, the main reason why I'm changing the engine, so I want a little bit more power. My turbo is dead, it burns oil, and the pump is mechanical. Not much left for the gearbox removal.
My idea here is to drop it on my chest.
Gearbox is out.
And it's off. A little bit exciting.
I got the whole engine hanged back in the place with the gearbox, and now I'm going to fabricate the hinge. I want to move this bracket to this place, so it's going to be situated something like here. I have cleaned that part, maybe make a cut here, make a cut here, here, here.
Got this plate adapted.
I want to fabricate the hinge on this plate and then shape it. I made two cuts, 15 angle here, 90 degrees here, 90 degrees here, looking like that now, and it's fitting in perfectly.
I have finished reinforcing the bottom where I welded. As my father used to say, measure 9 times, then you can cut. I made a not very good measurements. It's not good, not sitting properly. I need to remake it. A few corrections. Lowered it here, because this side I didn't have a gap here, and the lower gap was really wider and it was not sitting straight. This hole is extended, now it's quite longer. The end is cut it off, it's not going to touch anymore the actual bracket. What's left here to fabricate the bracket for the muffler and make the reinforcements will be kind of finished. Fabricating the piece that's going to be welded to the actual. Perfekten Schlagen.
I got that part fabricated.
It's hanging. Other side of the bracket cut. It seems just this. Expected, not very accurate, but
I want to mount the fuel filter here, and I'm going to use an original bracket somehow. Now my bracket looks like that. I'm not going to be too picky with the welds. Oh, I have a crack here.
Finally got finished fabricating this bracket. Beautiful! Things are getting messy here. Too basic. Positive wires needed. Oh. One is black and blue. Another one is red and white. And the brown. And here, that's a good news. Okay, let's give it a go. Throttle body. This edge is going to prevent the actual hose not to blow off. And this is a port for intake manifold pressure sensor. perfection.
Temporary setup. Special tool for the turbo.
Building exhaust system with this catalytic converter, my Syncro is going to be running as quiet as Tesla.
This part is going to sit like this, is going to be welded here. Second part is supposed to be like that. Sits nice, as expected.
The last cut. Looks alright, looking good.
Now I'm going to weld everything. It's not going to be fresh and new, but it's going to be silent. Left side kind of finished. Finished welding.
Also, something to be recognizable as a TDI conversion.
Exhaust is done. So looking quite nice. Also, I have a TDI accessories. Beautiful.
Let's check the noise. How does it sound?
So my shred in the oil sump, that I have the spare one, is kind of jammed, so I'm going to use a wheel nut to, because this one is longer, and the main thing, it's going to catch the leftovers of the shred. You can see that it's going outside, and the original one is just a half, maybe a little bit more. So this is my whole idea. I'm going to mount this where it belongs, then bend the pipe here and cut it and weld it. So I made two cuts and it's going to look like that. I'm going to weld here and here. Yes, I agree, not the most beautiful fabrication that I have ever made, but it's going to be alright. This is how it's looking. This is a Teflon hose. It has no fears of oils and oil products. I have resprayed the right side of the engine and made a cut for power steering pump.
A fresh coat of primer. Feeling like I am Da Vinci and making my masterpiece. Also, this fabrication needs to get a fresh coat of paint.
This is how it's looking. Now what's left here, I will fabricate here a cover, but in my village I just simply can't get the material.